Goeiemôre. Ja, dit is nog laat môre. Dit is net op 11:00. Good morning, South Africa. Molweni, salam, namaste. Ek hoop daar is daar 'n paar van u. Dit is 'n vinnige hallo om te sê die pols klop, die hart brand en wou net graag vir julle kom hallo sê op hierdie Vrydag. I want to come say hello on this beautiful Friday. Dis 'n koue dag in die Kaap. Maar soveel mense vra waar is ek en hoekom hoor hulle nie van my nie? En kan ek net kom hallo sê? Ek het gister in een van ons great supporters vasgeloop en was net 'n ongelooflike oomblik om ons mense. Wie's ons mense? Suid-Afrikaners. UIM supporters, vriende, bure, mense, net om hulle te sien en 'n druk te kry en 'n hallo te kry en 'n bietjie liefde. En dit help. Good morning. Ja, it is Neil de Beer. If you can hear me en as die klank goed is, wil jy net gou-gou vir my dit druk. Net gou-gou vir my okay nie, want ek weet nie of ek op hierdie oomblik gehoor word nie. If I'm it looks like I am. Hey. While I'm talking this morning, could you maybe like this page, like this live and pass it on. Share. Ek wil 'n paar belangrike goed miskien net van my bors af kry oor gisteraand se toespraak deur Sukie Cyril by die sogenaamde State of the Nation Address. Soos jy weet, elke jaar nadat die president praat, dan sal ek opvolg met 'n opiniestuk. Soos altyd hier is ek, I'm here. I'm giving this opinion because I sat through that whole scenario last night. I listened. But not only did I listen, I unpacked this morning the entire speech, piece by piece, stukkie vir stukkie. Now, for those that don't watch matters of politics and for those that don't care for politics, like I at times do, I'm going to sum it up for you very quickly, but on Sunday, like every Sunday, I will be doing an in-depth analysis on the Biz News channel, which I do every Sunday as a commentator now, with a great journalist, Chris Steyn. Maar omdat ek die leier is van die UIM, is dit belangrik dat ek met u kommunikeer, dat ek met julle praat, and that I keep you up to date. Firstly, may I talk about where we are in the UIM after the election and after the waves of the election have now passed. It is 50 days, yesterday, 50 days after this country, although a very small percentage, went to vote. Dit is 51 dae vandag gelede nadat baie van ons stemme uitgebring het in die verkiesing. There can be no doubt that people are unhappy, that people are disappointed, but this is the past. Yes, it's been tough for me, knowing how close, how very close, the UIM with all its efforts got to getting a representative into parliament. In other words, moving to the next level. I am not a good loser. I've always wanted to win. And in many things in my life, I have been able to achieve that. But like many other people, I have failed in many things that I have tried to achieve. Daar's baie goed wat 'n mens nou kan terugkyk in jou lewe waar jy sê ons moes, ons kon, maar dit is verby. Dit het vir my 'n tydjie gevat. Soos maar met enige resies, met enige toename van kompetisie. Om net 'n bietjie te besin, om nabetragting te doen en om te kyk waar, hoekom, wanneer, wat, wie. The United Independent Movement is going through a national review internally and externally. The United Independent Movement has done a 2-month review on every single area that votes were cast, on every single area where we did bad, and yes, where we grew. I will be doing, with our leadership, a public Facebook and social media live when these results at the end of the month are put to table by the top leadership of the UIM. If you want to know where you are going, you need to know where you are coming from. The election was a massive fight, a learning curve, the first one on a national scale that we've taken part in. We are not done. We are by far not defeated. In actual fact, we are now warming up. We are warming up because we must be ready to keep this government, which now is a government of national unity, truly accountable. There is no more opposition. And I will make that clear. The DA, the Freedom Front, the IFP, and several other parties are now part of the government of national unity, which means they are the government and they have to perform. If you want to call MK party and the EFF as an official opposition, you are very confused, you are out of touch and very naive. I can say this because I know them. I can say this because I work in the political arena. Every day. I don't have an opinion about it. I'm in it. I am talking of fact. Not social media. Not media leaks. Or general opinion. I am in that cave. I am in that arena. I am in that box. En ek kan vir julle duidelik sê dat daar geen oppositie wat ordentlik is met 'n meervoudige IK wat op die vlak kan klim om die GNU partye op 'n verskillende hoër vlak tot boek kan bring nie. You just have to think about it. There is no other moderate, middle-aged, yes, slightly conservative-minded political party in this country that is left to take on the new government of national unity in respect of keeping them accountable. Go think about it. And if you go further, there is no other political party in this country that really keeps the minorities of this country in its entirety as its base, it's only the UIM. And being a party that does not classify people according to race, that does not care about your religious connotation, but that cares that our mighty God, that our country is put first. I want to make it clear. All the parties that are currently in the GNU, I'm telling you straight, went into the election on a ticket to sink the ANC. Not just to sink them, but to annihilate them. I was there. Again, I wasn't outside the multi-party charter. I was in it. Now let me tell you, the decision of the UIM more than a year ago to join the multi-party charter was not to work with the DA, was not to work with the Freedom Front, was not to work with the IFP, was not to work with anybody else because we wanted to. No, it was because there was a plate of food dished on the table with a clear objective that the people partaking in that menu would work together to remove, not work with, not coalition with, not support with, not correlate with, not partner with, but to remove and, if necessary, destroy the ANC from ever ruling this country. Is ons daar? Het julle my? Of is ons doof? Dis die feite. Not outside. Not perception. I was in it. Hoe sleg is ons geskiedenis en gedagtes om nou ewe skielik alles te vergeet. Not the UIM and not Neil de Beer. I have no loss of memory. I have no short-term memory. In actual fact, I have a memory of a huge elephant bull. Jy gaan nie nonsense met my kan praat nie, and you are not gonna sell your utter rubbish to me and the members of the UIM. Daar's hy, hier kom hy nou. They lied. I don't care. I don't give a damn. I am Neil de Beer. Someone lied. Nou, daar is nie 'n middelmatige woord tussen waarheid en lieg. Jy gaan dit nie by my kry nie. Jy gaan dit nie by my kry nie. Jy praat of die waarheid of jy lieg. Klaar. You either tell the truth or you bloody lie. There's no, you know, I had to bend the truth a little bit. You know, we had to tell a white lie. We had to, nee. In God se woord, waarheid, jok, lieg. They lied. Nou, daar's een ding. Of ek reg doen en of ek verkeerd doen. Of ek die regte besluite neem of die slegte besluite. Ek vat 'n donderse besluit. En ek staan daarby. I will die that way. Now you don't have to like me. You don't have to support me. You don't have to agree with me. But you can't deny the fact that I'm harregat about the truth. Not my truth, God's truth. I went into the multi-party charter so that we could take out the ANC. And we went to the elections We stood on podiums. We made speeches. We went on TV. We paraded in front of the media. I did. And I'll tell you, my voice, if they want to deny it, they can. But my voice in the multi-party charter was huge, acknowledged so by every other leader of now the GNU parties. They can't deny it. They can't deny it. But when it came to the end of the day, it was klaarmaak. The reality is that the multi-party charter did not perform, that we did not hit the numbers that we were supposed to, that we did not achieve 50 plus 1. But worse than that, I'm giving you the info. You don't have to worry. You don't have to speculate. You, the public, I'm informing you. So be patient. I'm telling you. Now that you know, I just tell the truth and I'm willing to die for it, like I have in the past. You don't have to worry. These are just the facts. Do with it what you want. Yeah? Do with it. The multi-party charter plus the parties that were not in the MPC, BOSA, Rise Mzansi, and others. They did not make it. They did not get the numbers. I mean, you saw it. The result was terrible. And I'll tell you why. MK, the loss of the ANC, the DA's projected numbering, BOSA's numbering, Freedom Front numbering, UIM numbering, was hugely affected by the radical leftist MK. Even the EFF suffered. The EFF declined. And that's where we now stand and say, okay, Patrick, here you go. What do we do now? Do we form a multi-party charter united opposition? Or do they talk and work out to keep the EFF, MK, out? Now, here's the statement. I don't think there was a choice. I will put that on record. Exalda Topi record, plus. I'm not stupid. I'm not an idiot. I was born at night, not last night. If you put down on a chart and say ANC, MK, EFF, or ANC, DA, and GNU, which one is better for the country? Not the best, not the ultimate, but better. Well, I'm sorry, then there's only one option. And that is where we are today. That's it. So, yeah, I buy that. I get that. I support that. And that's why it's important that the UIM, must know that what has happened now in the government of national unity is not to the point of us, therefore, to attack or destroy it. That will be wrong. Am I clear? It will be wrong. Jy breek nie af nie, man. So we are also not going to sit as the UIM and every day find fault in what this new government of national unity every day is doing. That's not intellectual politics. That's destructive. Ons kan nie elke dag sit omdat ons nie ons teiken behaal het nie. Ons nie die nommers behaal het nie. Nou sit ons buite en alles wat die government van nasionale eenheid doen, moet ons nou uitmekaar uitskeer en negatief wees. Dit was nog nooit ek nie en dit is ook nie u as die UIM nie. Dis nie ons gesindheid nie. Nee. En ek sê dit vir jou opreg. Ons gaan nie hierso sit soos 'n klomp hyenas en wag dat een val sodat ons hom kan byt nie. Dit is nie positiwiteit nie. Dit is nie patriotisme nie. Dit is nie Suid-Afrikaans nie. Wel nie volgens my nie. Kan u dink dat elke dag wag jy dat 'n atleet val sodat jou atleet kan wen? Dat jy sit daar en bid dat 'n ander seer kry en misluk sodat jy kan opstaan en sê, "Aha. Dit is nie hoe ek werk nie. Dit is nie hoe ons werk nie. Dit is nie eerbaar nie. Dit is nie loyaal nie." En ek is jammer, dis nie intelligent nie. You cannot feast on the hope that a government of national unity will fail so that you can walk around with the aha moment. That you can walk around and say, "Told you so." Just because you lost. Just because you didn't make it. This is wrong, South Africa. This is not the way that you show patriotism as a South African and that you show loyalty to your people. It is unintellectual. Nay, it is dumb to walk around and hoping that failure will make you a winner. Are you taking this in, South Africa? We must be in support. We have to be. But here's the other side. In Latin we say, audi altius partem, the other side. Is just because we now have hope that a government of national unity will correct and rectify all the stuff of the past that the ANC has done, does not give you a free pass. We mustn't get confused here. We mustn't make our loyalty and patriotism to a flag and a country not keep the people that are now there to be not accountable. I want to tell everybody here that the UIM is alive. You forgot that we are still in councils. You forgot that we are still in politics. You forgot that we still have councillors in metros in this country until 2026. So we are still 2 years relevant. We are still 2 years in the fight. We are still there. But what you will see in the next couple of months is a change of attitude of representation in local government. You will see a change of approach. You will see us becoming hugely involved in accountability. You will see that the UIM will take on the 2026 municipal elections. Daar's baie water wat onder hierdie brug moet vloei. The choice of political parties are becoming less and less. You could see at SONA last night the total capitulation of opposition. Jy kon dit sien daar. Jy kon sien dat daar geen oppositie was nie en dat daar geen terugbeklei was op enigiets wat daai sogenaamde president gesê het nie. And here's a fact. Here's a fact. Ja, maar die ligte is nou af. Here's a fact. They mentioned a couple of stuff. And they mentioned a few stuff not. Baie interessant vir my. You see, when you talk to me, I don't normally just listen to what you say. No, I listen to what you are not saying. Jy sien wat jy in 'n gesprek vir iemand sê is obvious. Maar wat jy nie sê nie, dit is vir my meer belangrik. It was as if Cyril Ramaphosa has not been present in this country at all. He spoke as if he was not the president in the past 5 years. That he was not the vice president in this country for the previous 5 years. It was as if he got up and said, this is my mission. We have to fix schools. We have to fix municipalities. We have to look at roads. We have to fix rail. We have to get more energy. We have to beneficiate more of our own product. We have to attack. And I looked at him and I went, "Waar's jy? Waar was jy? Hallo, Cyril. Waar was jy?" Sorry, that's my analysis. He started his first ever presidential speech by calling it Tumamina. Translated, send me. Then he came up with this brilliant individual called Tenswalu. So send me to the life cycle of Tenswalu. And last night, the weaver birds. He said we should be weaver birds. We should get together like weaver birds and build a nest together. My opinion in one sentence is, if it wasn't for the government of national unity and the concept of it, Cyril Ramaphosa last night would have had zero to say to this country. Waar was julle? Now, what did he not say? He didn't speak about the Bella Bill. He wouldn't speak about the opposition whom all sat there and fought the Bella Bill and now shut up. He didn't speak about foreign relations, Russia, Ukraine. And the very touchy one, Israel, Palestine. He wanted to touch this Flossie, this aeroplane wanted to touch the NHI Flossie on the ground. And he just touched and then he took away again because he knows he couldn't spend 5 minutes on the NHI because they don't agree. Shockingly, he said nothing about our defense force. He said nothing about the military. He said nothing about what is going on in our military and our dying men and women outside this country. He didn't acknowledge the soldiers who just in the past year died for their country. And this is the commander-in-chief of what? Jy is nie eens 'n kopperaal. Moenie eens dink aan 'n generaal. There was no acknowledgement of any of our brave soldiers who are sent outside their country, in my opinion, for no benefit, with no support. He didn't even say thank you. Not even to mention, not a singular bloody word on the continued failure of this country to look after their military veterans, which I am, without a doubt, one of them. Nooit. Nie 'n woord oor plaasmoord. Nie 'n woord oor hoe die moord en doodslag in hierdie land aangevat moet word nie, maar hy praat oor die bloody weer en die probleme met brande. What kind of speech does not acknowledge that the country is not just burning and drowning, but is currently collapsing because of murder, mayhem, injustice, and a failure of an ANC government to the people. But now they are back again in government. You should have seen the speeches of all the leaders, except for the MK and EFF cabal. Every political leader clapping hands and saying what a great leader and great speech Cyril delivered. Dit is skokkend vir my. Again, we are talking about projects and programs. You see, Mr. President, I would do anything to believe you. My Bible says we've got to give acknowledgement to the king. Your government. Gee die koning wat hom toekom. Ek het net een koning. En dis God. Daar is nie ander koning vir my nie. So I'm telling you, out of the 26 things you said last night within 1 hour, nothing new, nothing great, nothing exciting, because it came from your lips like before. No Zondo Commission. No Zondo Commission. No Pala Pala. So the things that I wanted the opposition of the past to change is the Bellable, is NHI. And here's the biggest one. BEE. Hy sit wragtig gisteraand voor al die partye wat gesê het dat BEE onmiddellik gestop moet word. Hy staan daar en in sy speech sê hy baie clear, we will promote BEE and strengthen that kind of transformation. Bellable, NHI, BEE. Yo. Shocking. So when I say I want to give this government of national unity every space, every room, every capability, every positive support, it's because I'm a South African patriot. But because I'm a patriot, you are not going to get away with not making a point of fighting for why you were voted in. You didn't vote me in. I asked God why. I'm getting some answers. This will be in His hands. Dit gaan in sy hande wees. Maar ek sien meer en meer mense kom UIM toe. Selfs daai wat nog nooit te my geglo het. Die mense, ek is al 3 jaar besig om te beklei vir die land. Ek het nog nooit my siel verkoop nie. Ek het nog nooit weggestap nie. Ek het nog nooit my storie verander nie. Ek het bedank uit die NPC omdat ek my woord gegee het. Ons het nie ons sitplekke gekry nie, want ek sê vir jou, dit was nie God se hande nie. Dit was nie sy bestemming. Ek moet dit glo, want ek is 'n Godskind. I have to believe it. I have to say that when I said before the election that this will be in God's hand, ek vertrou op my God. Ek is in sy hande. God is my IEC. God is my IEC. You, the people, are the IEC to me, not the IEC. That came, that judgment. Ek weet nie hoekom nie. Dit het ons seer gemaak. Maar nou weet ek hoekom. I think God wanted us to be outside. I think if we were inside, if we got that seat, if we got part of the GNU, then we would actually also be forced to become silent. Ek glo dit nou. Glo my, ek het geworstel hiermee. Elke dag, hoekom? Ek het dan so hard gewerk. Ons mense het so hard gewerk. Julle het so hard gewerk. En toe kom het vir my duidelik. God het nie met my gepraat nie, daar was nie 'n visioen nie. Want dis nie my God wat dit elke dag doen nie. Maar ek dink hy het my net wysheid gegee. Dit het net hier opgekom. Ek dink waar hy net gesê het. Keep them accountable. Dis dit. Jy sien, as jy deel daarvan is, kan jy nie uitpraat nie. As jy deel daarvan is, kan jy nie skree nie. As jy deel daarvan is, kan jy nie die foute net uitwys nie. Ek was al deel van daai stelsel. So UIM, that's where we are. I have a job. I have 2 jobs. One, it's promote my God on earth. I don't get paid for that. You idiot. Now you, here. You're an idiot. You don't know me. I don't do things because of money. I do it because I'm passionate about it. Because I love my country, I'm willing to die and I'm willing to take on any enemy that will denigrate my God and that will sink my country. I am known for that. What are you known for? This is not a game. This is for the people. En nou gaan ek eindig om te sê, nou gaan ek seker met die volgende ding wat ek vir julle sê. Weer mense verloor. Weer mense kry wat gaan sê, stappie saam met daai manie. Wel, hoor gou-gou, blok, delete, beweeg aan. As die volgende statement, nie jou pas nie. This is a democracy and I can say what the hell I want to, as long as it doesn't harm and doesn't break down anybody. But an idiot is an idiot. The problem with an idiot is that an idiot doesn't know he or her. He's an idiot. You have to help them. Dis die ding met 'n idioot. Jy het al gesit in 'n gesprek met idioote. En daai idioot gaan net aan en aan en die rede is want hy weet nie, hy's 'n bloody idioot nie. Jy moet sê ekskuus tog, hou gegaan, dames en here, maar ekskuus tog meneer, jy's 'n idioot. Dis nie 'n skokkende ding nie. This isn't rude. You're an idiot. Jy's 'n idioot. Dit is soos iemand wat 'n dingetjie op sy mond het nadat hy 'n mayonnaise sandwich geëet het. Dit irriteer die lewende hel, want hy sien nie die kolletjie van wit mayonnaise nie. Jy wil met hom praat, maar die kolletjie trek jou aandag. Dit is jou werk om te sê, "Ekskuus tog, Jan, vir net gou jou back off, want daar's mayo oor jou hele gesig." Dit is dieselfde met 'n idioot. Jy moet vir hom sê, "Ekskuus tog, meneer, jammer, maar jy's 'n idioot. Jy maak my kop seer." Daar's hy. This is life though, South Africa. We are going to be surrounded with idiots. Now you either accept it or you die. I have accepted it. We will meet idiots. Treat them with compassion. Be kind. Be nice. It's like getting a dove with a broken wing outside on a rainy garden. You can either squash it back into earth and create compost, but if you are kind, pick it up, put it in a box with tissue paper. This is a decision. I prefer the kindness. So here it comes. Here is it. Reguit. Someone asked me if I am a Donald Trump supporter. Or a Biden supporter. And I looked at that person and I said, I am unashamedly, irrevocably, a supporter of Donald Trump. And it is my right, it is my choice, it is my democratic right to say who I support, although nothing to do with me. But out of experience, out of like, Donald Trump's my guy. Always has, always been. Again, not everything of Donald Trump. No, nie alles van Donald Trump. Hou ek van nie. Net soos met my. Julle hou sekere goed van my glad nie. Maar daar is net 'n paar goed waarvan jy like. Nou hier is die ding. Gooi daai wat jy nie van my hou nie weg en kom ons bou op die goed waarvan jy like. Want ek weet jou as ek jou ontmoet oor 'n Olofberg of 'n goeie koppie moerkoffie, gaan ek ook omdraai en sê, "Ja, daar's hulle van daai goed. Kyk hoe kou hy oopmond." Maar hy's 'n goeie ou. So daar's hy. If you don't support me now anymore, if you want to walk away because Neil de Beer said he likes Donald Trump, daar gaan jy. Doesn't mean the United Independent Movement is now going to write letters of support and accolade to Donald Trump. No. But it just means that the president of the UIM, Neil de Beer, dad, grandfather, neighbor, and dude, I support Donald Trump. And if I was in the United States of America and I could vote, daar's hy. Trump. Ek dink ek het nou baie gesê, ek het nou baie mense geïrriteer en ons het 'n paar idioote uitgelig. Maar vir almal van julle, nou op hierdie live. Ek is gesond. Ek is okay. Ons is deur die golwe. Ons is besig om op te warm. Ons is besig om vir die mense te sê, ons het julle nie gelos nie. Ons gaan julle nie los nie. En ek gee nie hel om of ons 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 80, 90 duisend mense het wat agter ons staan nie, en dit is al wat ons het nie. Just remember, your attitude defines your altitude. And I've said this, en ek gaan dit aan mekaar sê. my God eerste en my land tweede. Maar al twee so na aan my. Vir daai mense wat elke week vir my sê, I must stop talking about God. I must stop talking about my religion. I am not a perfect Christian. Then hear me well today. Will remove me from my God, Jesus Christ and the Holy Ghost. Jy moet uit my pad uit klim. As jy my van my God wil, ja, ek het foute. Ja, ek is nie perfect nie. Ek wil vir julle sê, ek het tot met, ja, hier kom het nou, ek het met Royes Strauss, ek het met Royes as jy hier is, Royes as jy my hoor, ek het my strydbuil, ek het my hand, ek het my verhouding met Royes Strauss, direk tromp op, gaan uitsorteer. En ons het mekaar ontmoet in die middel. Royes. Ja, ons het. Daar's foto's. Maar daar's een ding wat ek aan daai man respekteer. Daar's seker baie. Ken hom nie. Maar daar's een ding wat ek respekteer oor 'n ou soos Royes. Al is hy hard. Hy het op na my toe gestap. Hy het nie weggestap nie. Hy het nie teruggetrek nie. Ons het soos twee buffelbulle wat mekaar aangekyk het, die mense om ons het verskrik teruggestaan en ek het gestap en ek het sy hand geskud en ons het gepraat. Dit is respek. Dit is hoe, want al twee van ons, maak nie saak nie, al twee, ek en Royes, ons al twee op die einde van die dag is kinders van God. Feite. Ek het gevra en hy het al gevra 3 keer, kan ons nou brood breek? Broers in God moet brood breek. En ons gaan. That's honor, that's respect. That's how you do it. There's no enemy in God. You're either with God or you are against. So stop telling me that in my politics, in my speeches, that everything I do, I must stop bringing God in. Nou, nou daai kan ook maar nou waai. Nee, God first. God is my president, God is my leier, God is my speaker, God is my vader. So, as jy nie van my politiek hou in God nie, klim uit, get out. Klaar. Maak skoon. En tweedens, as jy nie Suid-Afrikaner in jou hart, in jou bloed en in jou passie is nie, klim uit. Ek wil jou nie hier nie. I don't want you here. Get out. God, Suid-Afrika. God, Suid-Afrika. God 1, Suid-Afrika 2. As jy nie daarvan hou nie, klim uit. Waai. Maar ek sê jou, jy gaan maar min ander keuses hê as hier. Binne 'n week van nou gaan ek 'n live doen waar ek gaan sê wat ons missie is in die volgende 2 jaar. Ons gaan dit duidelik maak. Ek kan al klaar vir julle sê. Weermag, militêre veterane, ons het genoeg gehad. Ek is een, ek is 'n unieke een, ek het 2 badges. En ek gaan hulle saamvat dat ons gaan fight. Want ek het genoeg gehad dat ons veterans op die grond lê. Maak nie saak watter kant jy beklei het nie, jy het beklei. Hou op om my in te trek, een en die ander, gee my daai respek. Gee my net daai respek dat ek daarom bereid is om vir almal te beklei. So jy kan maar vat, dit kom. Plaasmoorde, ek gaan dit fight, het dit gefight, sal dit fight, gaan nie ophou nie. Ja, plaasmoorde. Dan, absoluut misdaad. Ons gaan nie die Bella wet los nie, Ons gaan nie wegstap van grondbesit as jy grond besit nie. Ek sien daar word nou gebrom oor die eienaarskap van privaat wapens. It is a pity that in this country it's not enshrined in the Constitution like it is in the United States, where it says in the United States Constitution that the citizens of the United States have the right to bear arms. Maar dit is hier, dis in ons wet ook. Dit is daar. As jy 'n vuurwapen koop en jy dit gelisensieer en dit is jou eiendom, het jy die reg om dit te dra. Jy het die reg tot selfverdediging volgens die strafproseswet. So, ek sê dit op rekord. Jy vat nie aan ons wapens nie. Dit is 'n reg. Dit is 'n wet. We can put statistics. Statistics. Kan ons gooi. It's not the weapon that kills. It's the person handling the weapon. And until we can't get a guarantee in this country that illegal weapons, that people that have police weapons, that people that steal them, and that people use them, that until you can't tell us that such weapons of illegal hands are not taken away, then how can you even debate taking away the weapons of the normal citizen? How can you even start discussing looking at removing private security companies' guns, tightening it up and reducing access? How can you suggest that when you know that currently 80% of crime in this country is in actual fact not solved by the police? It is solved by private security. Ja, there must be control. Ja, daar is sira. But I tell you this today, you take away private security, this country has gone to the dogs. Ons lê nog op katvlakte nou. Maar as hy hondevlak toe gaan, dan is ons stelselmatig moord toe. En die rede hoekom die mense wat nou in autoriteit sit, nie die erkenning gee aan privaat sekuriteit maatskappye in die land nie, is because they either are ignorant, they are dumb, or they are lying. Dom, astrant, of arrogant. Daar's 100 of so 1000 polisiemanne. Daar's 600,000 sekuriteit. Do the maths. MAFFHS. Maths. We can't now start changing because you want to bloody change. A new broom does not always sweep cleaner. It can at times damage. So I'm saying, these are the matters that count in our country. These are the things, the bread and butter. Maar Johannesburg, Murtu, Pretoria, Murtu, Bloemfontein, Murtu, Durban, Murtu, PE, Murtu, West London, Murtu. Murtu. Maar nou kom die president gisterand en hy sê, hulle is Murtu. Jy het hulle Murtu gemaak. Jy. Maar wragtig voor Godslig staan daai man gisterand en hy sê, die metros is Murtu. Huh? Jou kar slaan aan die brand, jy klim uit, al die mense spring uit, jy loop om die mense, en jy staan saam met die mense en kyk hoe brand jou kar en lewe kommentaar. Maar as jy nou, is jy nou, is daar, Is daar varke weg? Die wielietjie draai. Die hamster is dood. Hy's moer toe. My closing remark. The citizens of South Africa are not stupid. We might be ignorant. But we're not stupid. So the UIM will choose 10 points in the next 2 weeks as our declaration of our 2026 campaign. We'll declare it now. Terwyl ander partye nou moet onthou wat hulle beloof het, nou moet beklei om wat hulle beloof het stil te maak en om nou in te kom om hierdie land te draai soos hulle nou beloof het, is ons al reg om beter te doen in 2026. Is ons besig om nasionaal al klaar met mense te praat om te vra, kan julle en sal julle as 'n raadslid staan vir die UIM in jou wijk, in jou dorp, in jou area? This is a call for duty. This is a call to national service. This is a call that we get and take back our authority in the places that actually are important to us, our municipalities. Of jy nou 'n skrynwerker, skoenmaker, mechanic, ingenieur of elektriesien, onderwyser, polisieman, dokter of nurse. Ons vra jou om te dink om na ons toe te kom en namens ons in julle rade te gaan sit en ons te verteenwoordig en op te staan tussen die kabaal, tussen almal wat nou beloftes gemaak het. Ons vra jou, die normale Suid-Afrikaner, die normale dag tot dag ordentlike, respectvolle Suid-Afrikaner, ons soek julle. Daar kan nie een munisipaliteit in hierdie land wees waar daar nie 'n UIM persoon gaan sit nie. Ons vra julle. We've done this before. Ons het 2 jaar. It's a call for service. No matter who you are. Come help us. That's how we started. And that's how we will end. A party for the people, by the people. To the people. Tjo. Winter buite en nou is ek sommer warm binne. Ek wil sê baie dankie. Ek wil sê dankie vir julle wat nog nooit opgegee het nie. Elke keer daai boodskappe stuur om te sê ons mis julle, ons is by julle. Baie, baie dankie. To those that daily send us messages that continue to drive us on this platform and give us the energy, the love, the hope that this was not all for nothing. That this was and is an important task that we are doing. We will never surrender. The UIM will never stop. Because this is about you. It's always been about you. And it will always be about you. Alles wat ons doen, van die oggend tot die aand, is vir die verryking en die verryking van ons God Vader en die mense van die Republiek van Suid-Afrika. En nog een dingetjie. Ons is baie gelukkig met ons volks- en landslied. Ons is gelukkig waar ons is. Moenie Peter die man. Moe nou nie 'n ding gaan krap wat rustig lê onder 'n krummetartboom en op hierdie oomblik maar net rustig is nie, né? Let us continue. May God bless this country. May God bless you, your family, your loved ones. And may God bless this very fine Republic of South Africa. Mag God se rykste seën oor julle wees, julle familie, julle vriende, julle besigheid, julle werk. Maar meer as dit, hierdie ongelooflike Republiek van Suid-Afrika. Lekker naweek as daar 'n oelofie is, vat hom. As daar 'n choppie is, kou hom. En as daar 'n geliefde is, druk hom of haar styf vas. Want die toekoms is in God se hande, maar ons moet iets daaromtrent doen. Lekker by, dankie vir hierdie ongelooflike tydjie met julle. Vir al die likes, al die harte, alles baie dankie, ek waardeer julle. Sit in die kar en die mense stap verby en dink ek is nie lekker nie. Nee, ek is nie 'n idioot nie. Ek is eintlik vinnig. Love julle altyd sonder twyfel. Love you. Thank you. Bye-bye.